Hello, I'm Mel. I'm socialmediatraffic.com, creating a Facebook profile picture using GIMP, demonstrated and narrated by John Lee Messney.
I'm going to open up a profile picture that is the extent of the size that Facebook allows, and I'm going to replace it with another picture and then save that and then upload that to my Facebook profile. Let's start by this is the GIMP, and of course it has more than one window. Here's my toolbar along with my image templates. By default you'll probably see something like this, which are the settings for the currently selected tool. Currently I have the paintbrush selected, and so these are contextual settings for paintbrush. And I'm going to right click on this center window here and go to the file menu and choose open as layers. That's going to give me a new dialog which I'll fit into my capture area, and I'm going to open up a picture in downloads, which is the picture, my profile picture that I downloaded. So when I open it, what happens is I get this dialog. It says, do you want to have the same color style? I would always say convert. And so here's my resultant picture at exactly the right size. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to import another picture on top of it. You can see over here I have a single layer, and that is the background image that I just imported. So when I right click here and say open as layers, this time I'm going to go to my desktop where I have a picture that I want to replace my profile picture with located. And you'll see that the picture is much bigger than the original picture. And so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to select my move tool in order to move that layer to sort of see if I just want to crop it or whether I actually want to resize. And I think I want to resize. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the resize tool, the scale tool. I'm going to click on that, making sure to reset it as a starting point. And then I'm going to click on this little set of chains. And what that does is constrains the image, because otherwise I'll just end up stretching it. And for some reason, it's not working. There we go. So now, as I scale down, what's happening is that picture's getting smaller, and it's getting smaller proportionally. I'll reset it one more time, make sure there's no stretching. And with constraint turned on, I'm just going to set this to, let's say, 600. Whoops. And so what that's done is it's made it much smaller. I'm going to say scale. And now I'm going to use my move tool again to move that layer into place. I'm going to align it with the top of the image, and I'm going to add another layer. And the reason I'm going to do that is to cover the bottom portion of the image there. So you can see now I've covered that additional layer with a black layer. I'm going to put that underneath of the other layer, and there's a strange transition from the bottom of the photo to this black. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the eyedropper tool in order to select the bottommost color and make sure that I'm selecting my topmost image, choose that color, come back into the new layer, and I'm going to use the bucket fill tool in order to fill that with a color that matches the rest of that photo. Here I have the image that I want, and I'm going to go ahead and save that and upload it to my profile picture as a replacement. Now when I do that, some interesting, sometimes confusing things can happen. So I'm going to say save a copy, at which point I get this dialog, and it asks me what and where I want to name it as. I'm going to save it to my desktop as a Facebook profile .png. One of the interesting things about GIMP is that I can just save it with a file extension, and it will recognize that I want to save it as that file type. So I'll go ahead and say save, and I get this dialog. It says PNG does some interesting things with layered images. Do you want to merge those layers, or do you want to flatten the image? I'm going to say merge. I click on export. It gives me some settings about PNG, which I usually leave at the defaults. I'll say save. It exports it, and now I'm back in my original image with the layers, but on my desktop is a nice composite image in PNG format of all of those images. I hope that this was useful for you.
Social media traffic. For tips and strategies, get free instant access. Go now to my website, imsocialmediatraffic.com.